God, he's got the reactions of an absolute monster. Triggers out the Blade Fury as the dunk comes in and just dodges out all the damage.
Purifying flames. However, this could still be okay for Onyx. Dubu gets low. Harry Potter makes it up to the high ground. It's a 2-for-0, but here comes the Weaver and Abed with a combo on 4. Oh my God, it's Harry Potter for real as Abed.
Behold my searing chains.
Beginning of the end here, Rand has been targeted out and quickly executed. He'll be removed from the game for about 40 seconds. No buyback.
Dire structures.
Bulma begins to go to work. CG playing on the back, even on the outside. The tank is tossed to Mitch there for break. We'll take him out. The sniper out of this one. Doesn't have a buyback. He's going to have to use it. Abed, jump it back and forth. Gets the triple. Threading through fire where possible. Finally, the Star Spirit will be halted, but it's just going to be his first life. Looking to come back and finish what he had started. He jumps right back in for Fluff. Fluff cuts his hair, goes for the next one. Whitebeard's next. Let's chase this guy.
Oh, over here
this
now.
Is it.
I'm over here.
Zap! The world loses an exquisite toxin.
The steam is out, but he got the rampage right at the end.
After the Aphotic Shield is popped, 747 gets a double kill. It's a nice black hole as well as a chaotic offering. But now what do? You don't have the chaotic offering. You don't have the black hole. Now you don't have an enigma. Now you don't have the invoker. You get the hoof stomp double edge out on 2. But Centaur, he's looking to be in more trouble. A perfect echo stomp comes through from SVG. Now you're without 2 of your big time cores. So they're looking to get the racks. New coming in with the Thunderclap, putting himself in harm's way. There's the magic missile. Slithering Crush comes on through from Rose. They'll get another kill. Chaotic Meteor, or Chaos Meteor comes on through. As I keep saying that phrase, I'm really trying to get off it. He's fought back. He's in a little bit of trouble with that Aphotic Shield. He will survive for a little bit longer. Will this tornado do it? It will. But just like that, they've lost Eternal Envy, but the Rampage is there for AUI. He takes out the Invoker, Z-Freak, Swindle Melons, Moo. The Rampage continues, all 5 dead on Complexity, and despite losing Eternal Envy on this Alchemist, they'll wipe the entire team.
Mid one has the higher white damage, though, especially when he has meta. So double damage is going to give him, like, 250-ish damage.
Here they come. Loader is the bait. Let's see if they take it, and yep, they do. Loader unable to get the rage off in time, and the hookshot forward, Innocent Farm, couldn't do anything. The amount of damage he's taking is ridiculous! Mid one, the attack never dissipated. Vengeful Spirit gets stunned up, he'll go down as well. They're waiting in a ceremonial position for EGM, and now he'll tether up. The Ghost of buys a little bit of time, but there's Angry Bears on the front lines, and Loader is a triple kill and die back over on him. EGM will fall as well, and that's the game. There is no way Alliance can defend against that team.
With the boulder smash here, lines up the shot. Oh, he doesn't. Forgot he couldn't pick the stone.
Drop the stone and walk past it, I guess.
Yeah, don't know if they really wanted to commit into a tier 1 either, so. But yeah, maybe a slight little mistake there for Taka. 9?
Ooh.
And tornado dunk.
Oh!
Okay.
Oh!
Beautiful combo.
Almost officially going to be out of control, because, like, him getting the Radiance is not the end. It's not, oh god, he has a Radiance, the game's over. But
right.
It's more about, like, what have you gotten in the process? And I don't think Wings has really gotten all that much. They're finally going to take this mid-tier 1 tower, about 15 minutes in. They've taken the safe lane tower, but that's all. The rest of OG, they've kept their off lane tower alive. They've gotten a lot of fun. Centaur.
And this Fisher, oh my god, it blocks off 3. They're all going to die. Blink is dead as well. They don't even get the Visage. They don't even get his birds. Oh no.
Oh,
oh my god. I just look over and I'm like, they're 3 heroes stunned by a Fisher from Jerex.
Wow.
Oh jeez. Really take down anybody there, but they are still dominating this side of the map. And it's just completely hemming in Wings.
Jerix does also have Fissure again. He stole that from the Earthshaker a little while ago, and we'll have Radiant's it for the next fight.
Nice.
He's got to throw down that Enchant Totem a little bit more. Yeah. It's difficult.
It's really hard not to.
Oh god, they got two! Oh no, Faithion is on the wrong side as well. That's gonna end up being three dead. A great combination. Maybe Faithion gets out, they throw out the Echo Slam. Is it gonna be enough? S4 running away, he's not quite going to drop. Oh, 67 HP. Oh, another fuck off! Jerix, he's all over the damn place! He had Light Strike Array as well, threw it back onto him!
Oh my god, this game's over.
Holy shit, that was awesome!
Jerix just executed that whole entire wing squared.
Alchemist is probably gonna hit his like first real like, okay, I'm ready to fight now, kind of timing. Maybe he thinks it's the shivers, like the Octarine plus the shivers, so he gets Amaranth as well. Kind of depends if he dies again, but he's still very far ahead, so he may be looking to fight fairly soon.
Jump onto RMN. Ramses will get the bash, will find the kill, and now the RP to counter initiate, cleaving through two, and now chasing onto that Ursa. I think Pycat can hunt him down. There's the skewer. Ramsey's getting slowed down. He's going to have to turn and fight the hole still ready. And General not going to use it. Keeps him reserved. They bring down for Dendi. Well, I said he hasn't had to come up big just yet, Gods. And right after that, he delivers.
You kill it, but it doesn't do anything for you. Like, right. Objective. Because the heroes just back up.
Oh, what?
Timing.
Oh, baby.
Sick.
That was really cool. That was really, really cool. Fenrir is going to die, too.
Here comes Liquid. Right under the vision. Be watching this approach. Reading these movements. Yeah, they do. I see the ward there. Manuvia already on the way. Trying to catch them while they go for the D ward.
Oh, he gets
beautiful catch. SCCC, my god! Gets a beautiful pullback onto him, is able to burst right through Mind Control and the Dazzle, but can they get the clutch finish here? Liquid able to hold their ground and fight it out with their own Abyssal play. Can't they get the burst through? They're still holding on. Blinding Light to bump them back, and now they look to focus and surround the top of man. They will get the Aegis down. Sliding and scooting away, GH trying to make a retreat. Forced to leave, Matumaman back in behind. Him and Miracle, the slow movers, trying to get out from this one. Matumaman will get first down, he has no buyback. Frantic to make it out, Omni Slash is there. SEC is gonna be forced to go down and go right into a buyback. KP, no buyback for him. GH re-engaging, will end up losing his life. But as Miracle makes his return, he should be also going down here and he will get dropped. He does have a buyback, but Matumaman does not.
Was that a five-man vortex?
It was monstrous.
Oh my god, that is ridiculous. You could still see though that how strong Miracle really is. They even just were like, we can't just fight.
Oh, actually want to make it in the middle here, but Io is nearby. So yeah, there comes the tether, seeing that the gank attempt is being had by Mickey. He's going to back over a turn kill. The patient comes out, but actually Nice Doctor's in trouble. Mickey will get the turn kill on one, get the turn kill on two, a double kill. And the regen kicking in from the bottle as well, and it's going to be a triple kill on top of it. Come With Me gets credit for that last kill, but it might as well have been a hat trick, really, for the two of them. Beautiful play on both parts.
I can't believe he survived. Well played by Come With Me. I mean, Mickey was obviously
the fact that gold-wise here.
Yeah, against an Alk lineup.
Alright, they got a really good stomp, follow-up stun.
They
this could be Onyx's life. Life number one, but Voodoo actually gets a really good initiation. Will get a lot of chaos out there. They're gonna try and stomp, but that's not where the real Meepo is.
Oh, he
he's gonna be put forward and manage to finish off the Winter Wyvern, catches AUI as well. Now goes for MSS. He managed to get a really good table concoction. Envy commits to this fight. They'll die in this fight too.
That is gonna be a rampage.
Gonna be cleaned up as well. Rampage for Ahmed Meepo.
Double crit. If MJW was just a second slow, and that's melee rack, they blink lift him up as well. BKB not activated just yet, and Abing has a BKB. Just standing in the front line, actually pops his ult, taking a ton of damage here. He does go down, the Aegis will spawn, but this is what happens when you jump in initiate. BKB's already used. Abing's gonna get three shots. The hammer gets dropped, the back wall, it's gonna be great. My god, a Mel! Dropped against Ohm Hammer, and that was the hammer of Doom here as BKB just takes the rack with the help of Illusions.